Here's a basic algorithm you can use to implement diffusion simulations and simulate a molecular communication system. Simulations play an important role in testing the behavior of a system and verifying results. Simple particle diffusion is fairly easy to simulate, so let's show one algorithm to do it and compare it with the channel impulse response of the unbounded point-to-point diffusion channel. This ideal system has one-point molecule transmitter, and we observe the molecules at some distance away. To simulate this system, we need to make a list of molecules to keep track of. For each molecule, we need to track its coordinates. Let's consider a 2D system, so each molecule has an x-coordinate and a y-coordinate. We run our simulation as a series of rounds, where each round advances time by a small amount called a time step. Within one round, we move all the molecules. To move one molecule, we generate a random number for each coordinate and shift the current coordinate by that amount. The random numbers are generated from the Gaussian distribution, also known as the normal distribution, and we scale the numbers by the diffusion coefficient d and the size of the time step. I mentioned in a previous video about how the diffusion coefficient is used in simulations. We repeat this position update process for every molecule, then keep running rounds for as long as we want. We can write this process as an algorithm with two for loops. Once we create our molecules, we use the outer for loop for each round, and the inner for loop to diffuse each molecule. We can implement this algorithm in practically any modern programming language, including MATLAB, C, and Python. It's easy to do if the language has a function for generating Gaussian distributed random numbers. We've talked about placing molecules in our environment, and we've described how we make them move. But what is the simulation output? We have some options here. One choice is to keep a record of all the positions visited by every molecule in every round. This would enable us to create a video afterwards, where every round is a video frame. A second choice is to focus on one specific area and only observe the molecules that enter that area. We could record the observed positions in every round, or maybe just the number of molecules observed in every round. Whatever output we choose, we can update our algorithm to include the recording. Simply recording the number of molecules is enough to make a time-varying plot. If we want to treat the observed area as a receiver, then the number of molecules in that area becomes our received signal. And hey, we've just simulated a simple communication system. You might notice that the received signal here is extremely noisy. This is because the random molecule diffusion carries molecules into and out of the observation area. You'll also see very different results if we repeat the simulation. This is because of the randomness. We can make the signal less noisy in one of two ways. We can simulate more molecules at once, or we can repeat the simulation many times and take an average. Either method will give us a smoother result, and this result might look familiar to you. As the noise is averaged out, we get a curve that matches the unbounded point-to-point diffusion equation, which we introduced in a previous video. What we've put together is a very basic particle diffusion simulator. We only have diffusion moving the molecules. There are no obstacles for molecules to hit. We've ignored molecules colliding with each other, and there are no chemical reactions. Nevertheless, this simple algorithm is the starting point for more sophisticated molecule simulations. And it's enough to perform communication system analysis. We'll be taking a look at communication system analysis, plus ways to make more complex simulations, in future videos. Thanks for watching! Did you learn something? You can let me know in the comments. You can also like the video and subscribe if you'd like to see more research highlights and tutorials on biophysical communication engineering. See you next time.